always such a popular final, the uneven bars competition. Always a highlight on the first day of competition at any World Cup or World Challenge Cup event. Here are your finalists. And there is some high difficulty that we're going to see in this competition, some real difficulty. Naomi Visser of the Netherlands, second best in qualification with the highest difficulty score. European Championship bronze medalist in 2020, Barbara Mokosova of Slovakia. Derin Tanriyashukur of Turkey, the fifth best in qualification, junior European Championship medalist. Leia Font of Spain, the eighth best in qualification. And the uneven bars at junior European Championship medalist, Maya Lasser of Spain, 20-year-old, seventh best in qualification. Jessica Dowling of Canada, who won her first international medal last year on the uneven bars. Zsófia Kovács of Hungary, gymnast who's three times a champion of Europe, including on the uneven bars in 2020. And Jenna Larouille of France, the 18-year-old from Lyon, third best in qualifying. Correction to Laia Font, Mediterranean junior uneven bars medalist rather than European Championships. There's the gymnast who's got the potential to win it if she stays on. In qualification, she had some difficulties, only a 7.033 execution, but the difficulty, 6.3. One-year-old from South Holland province. When you consider that her difficulty in qualification was 0.5 above the top qualifier, Zsófia Kovács, tells you just how complicated a routine Naomi Visser has. Barbara Mokosova. Two-time Olympian. She was the first reserve for the all-around final in Antalya at the European Championships earlier this year, at her 10th European Championships. This is Derin Tanriyashukur from Kadıköy on the Asian side of Istanbul. Won Türkiye's first ever women's artistic gymnastics medal at the European Championships when she was the junior uneven bars bronze medalist in Mersin in 2020. They went on to have a very fine championships, both women's and men's competition in Mersin in 2020. One of the highlights being Gökçü Uçtaşan's silver medal on floor. Leia Font in that same building in Mersin in June of 2022 won four medals at the Junior Mediterranean Championships, including a silver medal with the uneven bars. We begin this women's uneven bars final.
Ladies and gentlemen, representing Netherlands, Naomi Weiser.
Naomi Visser of the Netherlands, the national champion on the uneven bars. She competed at the European Championships where she made the final but had real problems. Highest difficulty, Stoldokachev to mix grip to the Ezhova. And that is where she's had some difficulties. She's off again. Oh, it's such a shame. It's such a hard routine. That first sequence. Extremely difficult. Now, it's still feasible that Naomi Visser could challenge for a medal. Stolderful into the chow. Paxalto straight back with the Van Leeuwen. It is, as we've seen before, 95% of an outstanding and highly competitive routine. There is massive scoring potential in that work from Naomi Visser. Just coming off the apparatus when she lost the handstand position. This one, it did go according to plan. The Stolda Shaposhnikova, popularised by Amy Chow. Visser's execution scoring qualification was 7.033. It's even lower on this occasion, 12.666, and she hasn't got the full difficulty because of coming off there, so she's down by 5/10 in difficulty. So that now has really changed the complexion of this final. Here is Barbara Mokosheva, the 26-year-old from Bratislava. Bronze medalist at her seventh European Championships in 2020. Maloney into a Paxalto. Then uses the Van Leeuwen. Just some form issues here and there. Pike Jaeger somersault. And the double tuck to dismount. Barbara Mokosheva of Slovakia. Always a threat when in a World Challenge Cup uneven bars final. She won a bronze medal in Mersin at her last World Challenge Cup competition. The issue is that there were just some clear form deductions here and there. But she's through the routine reasonably cleanly. Well, 0.966 in qualification, the fourth best score. .866 on this occasion. So Barbara Mokosheva down by just a single tenth from qualifying. Tanrıya Şükür of Turkey, fifth best in qualification with 12.666. International debut at the Mersin World Challenge Cup last year, where she was fifth in the uneven bars competition. From a difficulty standpoint, this was the lowest scoring routine of all of the qualifiers, but it was one of the better performed ones. Turkey's Derin Tanrıya Şükür, 16-year-old and from Kadıköy on the Asian side of Istanbul, made her European Championship debut at senior level last month. Good start, decent swingfulness, attacking the pack Salto. Did lose her form a little as she added the half turn to the Manlo lead to make it the Van Leuven. Nice Jaeger though, that was very clean. Just a little short coming up into the handstand position. Double pike to finish. Might be something of an issue, that previous handstand. You really, in this code of points, have got to get within that 10 degree margin of error with vertical handstands. Otherwise, the marks just fly off the score. Not always easy to tell from the camera angle. Yes, was her pike Jaeger. It's a good pike position. It was a well-performed skill. And the pike work to finish also looking nice. Derin Tanria Shukur. 12.666 in qualification. She competed at the Baku World Cup earlier this year, and her score is 12.5, just down a fraction from qualification, the execution slightly lower. Leia Font of Spain, 16, and already the two-time all-around junior national champion, eighth in qualification. Stolda Shaposhnikova, Pak Salto, is just losing her leg form a little, and it ultimately comes off. It never looked a fully secure start, unfortunately. Is the bail back to high. She's looking a little more swingful now. Nice tight pike position in the Jaeger, but the leg form is making things a little difficult. It's a good effort from Leia Font. You can see that there is real quality there, but that not the tidiest that she's ever performed at that particular routine. Still very early in her senior career. The promise for the future is very impressive. She's very competitive, Leia Font. She expects a lot of herself. She loves to win, loves to compete. She doesn't get easily overawed by a competition environment. Plenty of positives in this display. It's just the odd little flicker of the legs here and there as she's establishing those key skills. A slight asymmetry, almost a windmill action in the legs as she pikes round. Score 11.1 for Leia Font. Execution quite low. Now this is a reminder of the performance from Barbara Mokosova. I think we gave her difficulty scores 5.7 earlier. It was 5.1. That hasn't changed the total score. That was correct. Just a small typographical error. But just to confirm that 12.866 for Mokosova. And she is the leader at the moment. On we go to the second half of this women's uneven bars competition. Another young Spaniard. This is Maya Yasser, 20-year-old from Alcoy in Alicante. Very nice part of the country. Yasser made her World Championship debut in Liverpool at the end of last year. Did the uneven bars and floor. She is an undergraduate of Business Administration and Law at the University of the Balearic Islands in Palma de Mallorca. Itself an absolutely charming place. Uses the traditional Shaposhnikova transition, big arch of the back and the Pak Solto to the Maloney. The Ginger didn't really have enormous amplitude. She also came up well short going into handstand, so just fighting to get the swingfulness back. Lovely double layout though to finish from Maya Yasser. Some nice features in that routine. Gymnast who had good performances at the Luxembourg Open and in Jesolo outside of International Gymnastics Federation tournaments. And there the original Shaposhnikova skill, the hip circle transition. Real backbend as she executed the Pak Solto. And the toe-on Shaposhnikova, the Maloney variation. And she did get the power back when it came to the dismount. Wasn't a hugely confident Ginger somersault. We have three performances to come in this uneven bars final, including that of the top qualifier, Sofia Kovac. She's had to really bounce back, this young athlete, having missed out on the chance to be selected for the Olympic Games due to injury. She said, Yasser, that she thought it would be unbearable to sit at home and watch it. Instead, she fully embraced it, got up early for every session, didn't miss a minute of watching the gymnastics coverage. That takes a strength of character. I have to report to you that we are at the trying to switch leads around stage of proceedings in Varna. Anyone got a USB cable? Universal adapter? She might have a little wait here. Yasser. Still to come, Jessica Dowling, the aforementioned Sofia Kovac, and Jenna Larouille. quick nod at this stage to the first reserves for the finals. Lila Mackay of Hungary for this particular final for the forthcoming men's rings competition. Christos Marinov, the first reserve gymnast. The reserve for the men's floor competition was Sofus Hegemsnes, the Nordic all-around champion. For the women's vault competition, it was Lobar Amrileva. They're always there, those first reserves, waiting in the wings for their chance, and we've seen it happen at World Cup level, where people come in as a reserve and end up winning a medal. The score for Maya Yather. She's up by 0.2 from qualification. And as a result, with three to go, the Spaniard is in the bronze medal position. The leader remains Barbara Mokoshova.
Representing Canada, Jessica Dowling.
Canada's Jessica Dowling, the 28-year-old from Ontario. Sixth best in qualification. Nice straddle Jaeger somersault into the straddle Kachev. Loses the legs a touch. She's okay. And she just came up short coming out of that half turn. Gymnast who won her first individual international medal at the Mersin World Challenge Cup last year. It was silver on the uneven bars, having been a team silver medalist at the World University Games in 2017. Oh, that was wild. At least she made contact, but she's had to put in intermediary swing, and that's going to lead to further deductions. Very high amplitude dismount from Jessica Dowling. One imagines that there's just too much in there to have her contend for a place on the podium. Still, if you know the Jessica Dowling story, then you cannot fail to be impressed by it, by her determination, by her indefatigability when it comes to trying to win elite level medals and compete for a national team spot. The Canadian national team in women's competition did a wonderful job at the World Championships in Liverpool last year in qualifying a team for the Olympic Games by winning one of the shock bronze medals in the history of team competitions, really. And as a result, that allows the Canadian coaching staff to experiment a little with their squad selection for events like the Pan American Championships, for World Cup competition. It will give, one imagines, a lot of those gymnasts in the peloton for Canadian national team selection a chance to prove themselves at big competitions. Because of Canada's securing of the first available spot for the Olympic Games, or one of the three first available spots. They did it at the first time of asking. But it was a decade ago that Jessica Dowling had to learn to walk again after two very grueling knee surgeries. Did actually have a brief spell competing for the Netherlands. She has been an uneven bars medalist at domestic level too. 11.066. Jess Dowling out of medal contention. That guarantees Barbara Mokosheva, the European Championship bronze medalist from 2020, a medal, because she leads with two to go. And the gymnast who's next is the one who won that title in 2020. Zsófia Kovács, the Hungarian who was the all-around silver medalist at the European Championships last month. Top performer in qualification with a score of 14.3. Just take a moment to register that. 14.3 with a 12.866 leading the way. Chow with the half. That's difficult. It's a big Jaeger. Then she uses the downy into the pack salto. Well, that will be enough, almost certainly, to secure the crown. Zsófia Kovács of Hungary. Really good performance. If not the crown, a place on the podium. There is still one to go, but it's going to take some beating. She is such a driven young athlete. The Stolda Shaposhnikova with the half turn. First of those we've seen in this final. Pike Jaeger. Trying to really get up to vertical in the handstand position. So vital. The gymnast is within that 10 degree tolerance. It is Barbara Mokosheva who leads on 12.866 as things stand. She got so close to winning the European all-around title last month. The second time that she finished second in the competition after that performance in Romania, Cluj-Napoca in 2017. A Cluj-Napoca that is getting geared up to host the Junior World Championships of Rhythmic Gymnastics in July. Easy lead, 14.166, 5.8 for difficulty. Her execution close to the 8.5 that she produced in qualification. So now it is Kovács, followed by Mokosheva. And then, despite coming off, Naomi Visser is in third position. But we have now Jeanne Larue of France, the third best in qualifying with 13.133. Amplitude on the straddle Jaeger. Pack salto. And then a smoothly executed Inga somersault. Little short perhaps in handstand there. Oh! Big landing adjustment. That's a very interesting performance, though, from Jeanne Larue, the 18-year-old from Lyon. She's had some really good domestic results this year in the top 12 series, yet to win a senior national championship medal. Very promising performance, that. Early on, she was pretty well up into handstand. As the routine went on, perhaps she was a little shy. Certainly made a good case for getting close to the podium. That is going to cost, though. It's a very big landing adjustment. What's the outcome? For Jenna Lahui, and she has managed right at the conclusion of this final to take second place just ahead of Barbara Mokosheva by a matter of hundredths. The classified results in the uneven bars competition: the bronze medal to Slovakia's Barbara Mokosheva, silver to Jenna Lahui of France, her first international medal as a senior, and the title won by Zsófia Kovács of Hungary, and won well by over a mark. Despite coming off the apparatus, Naomi Visser almost securing third spot due to her high level of difficulty. The victory ceremony for the uneven bars competition at the World Challenge Cup in Varna, Bulgaria. Barbara Mokosheva of Slovakia, the bronze medalist. Her last World Cup competition was in Mersin last year, where she also took third place. You can't keep her off a World Challenge Cup podium. Jenna Lahui gets onto a World Cup podium for the first time. This is her biggest ever result internationally. Congratulations to the 18-year-old from Lyon. She takes second place and the silver medal. A great win for Zsófia Kovács of Hungary with a score of 14.166. This one was never in doubt from the moment that she landed at the conclusion of her routine. The European champion from 2020, the World Cup champion in Varna. And frankly, we're at the stage of her career now where whenever she's in a competition, you expect to see her on the podium. And you usually do. And we will have now the national anthem of Hungary. Zofia Kovac sparkling, positively coruscating in the Black Sea sunshine. The medalists in the uneven bars competition.